Did you wake up today and think something feels different? I'm Essie Cupp, welcome to Unfiltered. If you looked out the window and saw pigs flying, don't worry. Hell hasn't frozen over and you're not in the upside down or bizarro world. It's just 2022, when anything apparently can happen in American politics. Like Wyoming Congresswoman Liz Cheney, once one of the most conservative members of Congress and once a hallowed Republican name in Wyoming, just endorsed her first Democrat for Congress. Cheney's story by now is well known. Despite voting with former President Donald Trump 93% of the time, her mortal sin wasn't breaking with conservative values or principles. It was voting to impeach then-President Donald Trump, and now serving as vice chair of the January 6th committee. For this, she's been censured by her own party, vilified, and summarily voted out of office. So when she recently announced she was endorsing Michigan Congresswoman Alyssa Slotkin, a former Defense Department analyst and a Democrat, it was perhaps the logical conclusion to a wild and unpredictable ride the GOP has been on since Trump took the reins back in 2016. It is nevertheless remarkable to see how much the GOP has shifted in just the past 6 years, from one concerned with ideas and policies to one solely focused on Trump's irrational impulses. Cheney, like many conservatives who disavowed Trumpism, hasn't actually changed her positions all that much, but the party has changed dramatically around her. It's why people like Cheney and Congressman Adam Kinzinger and never-Trumpers like me are now frequently called progressives by right-wing MAGA supporters. Now, the notion is absurd. In fact, people like us rejected Trump not from the left, but from the right because he wasn't conservative enough, or frankly, conservative at all. For this, standing for conservative policies and rejecting election denialism, wanting accountability for January 6th, we now look like moderates. We often find more common cause with Democrats than Republicans. It's almost as if nothing means anything anymore, and the labels are now just used as pejoratives. To be clear, Cheney's endorsement of a Democrat for the first time isn't an embrace of all of Slotkin's positions, and she said as much in her statement this week. Plenty of Republicans, including me, voted for President Joe Biden knowing we disagree on policies. What Cheney is telegraphing is that conservatives like her might have more in common with some Democrats than Republicans in wanting to protect democracy from destruction. It's an important message. The question is, will there be enough Cheneys in the electorate? Enough voters who also decide to cross the aisle and vote Democratic for the first time to make a difference in the midterm elections? We'll have to wait and see. That's it for me. I'm Essie Cupp.